Hi, students. Welcome back. We've been talking to Amy Klein about her trip to Paris. You know, Amy, you wrote something that really caught my attention.
What's that, Vicki?
Well, you mentioned that if we really want to experience the true Paris, we shouldn't just look at buildings and museums all the time.
That's right. I think if you don't take time to stop and smell the roses, you're missing an important part of the Paris experience.
But that doesn't seem very easy with only a weekend and so many things to see.
That's true. There is a lot to see, but I'm glad that we did take time to stop and smell the roses.
Now, you mentioned the food was great. I know many things are expensive there. Is the food expensive, too?
The food's a little bit expensive, and the coffee especially.
Okay. Well, they had lots of coffee.
We did.
Well, there's one more place we have to visit in Paris.
You're right, Vicki, and that's the Eiffel Tower. Students, please read along with us as we start on page 16.
The Eiffel Tower. No Paris trip would be complete without a visit to the Eiffel Tower. Our hotel was just a few blocks from the famous tower, built for the 1889 World's Fair. Our last night in Paris, we took the elevator to the tower's lofty top. The tower's nighttime view is breathtaking. It helped me understand how Paris earned its nickname as the City of Light. One week